I'm Eeples Mox, here to make tech easier and more fun. Welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I've done a lot of these videos so far. They're all linked in the playlist in the video description. I've hopefully answered just about every question people could have about the software. So if you have questions, check out the videos. And if you want to know how this whole course works and such, check out the introduction video. It turns out that no matter how many times I'm asked for a solution to a problem, I'm much more likely to put together a solution when someone close to me is the one asking. My Twitch moderator, Dementia, wanted to stream his PS4, but add alerts and overlays and such to start diving into that Twitch PogChat life. He doesn't have a capture card, and his PC, the scrap pile gaming rig I could barely throw together for him to hold him over till he upgrades, is too far away for a capture card anyway. So what is the solution? What I had him do was live stream from his PS4 to YouTube as an unlisted live stream, then screen cap that live stream on the PC and stream that back to Twitch. For those of you cringing or adjusting uncomfortably in your seats, yeah, I said it wasn't elegant. For this, you will need a beefy internet connection. 10 or more megabits per second upload speed will be required. The PS4 can't stream over the local network, so it has to push out to a service like YouTube or Twitch, and then the PC is pushing a second stream out. He set up his YouTube channel connected to his PS4 and set the stream to unlisted. Start streaming and get the link of the stream page. Then go over to the PC. He pulls up the stream page in a browser window. You want this to be its own window, not just a tab. That way window capture can keep hooked on it in case you need to do other stuff on the PC. We set up window capture, turned off his computer speakers so it doesn't echo the stream throughout the room, and added the Streamlabs overlays. You need a beefy internet connection, but not a beefy PC for this. The build is an AMD Phenom 965 Black Edition, and maybe 8 GB of RAM, and a dying GTX 660 graphics card. Thankfully, that card is still new enough to support NVIDIA's NVENC encoder, which is basically the only way this streaming experience is possible. Set up a bitrate of 4 or so megabits per second, making sure not to use any other audio sources but the system's sound, since his microphone and such routes through the original PS4 stream, and the alerts will come through the system sound, and start streaming to Twitch. This isn't elegant. The default PS4 stream quality is already pretty low, and window capping a copy of it and recompressing it doesn't do it any justice. There's even more delay added to this process, and a much bigger desync between when someone follows or donates and when the alert goes off. But if you're desperate and really want to do this, you can. It works. Since the PC is far away and speakers were turned off to prevent an echo, he keeps a laptop pulled up in front of him with Twitch chat and his Streamlabs alert box so he can keep up with the chatters and when alerts happen. Like I said, this won't be a solution for everyone, but it's the best I've got without investing in proper streaming setups. I hope this episode of my OBS tutorial studio course, OBS studio tutorial course, I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. I hope the episode's been helpful for you, because it was a pretty cool solution that took a lot of work to figure out what exactly we could do. I tried a bajillion different things. This is what we came up with. If you liked it, hit the like button. Consider subscribing for more awesome tech content. Come follow me on Twitch or Dementia on Twitch if you like game streaming. Say hi in chat. Until next time, I'm Eeples Vox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more.